Hello everybody, I hope you are listening to me. So I welcome you all to this undergraduate program for the year 2020-21. And you know that English is the language we have to learn for this year along with one more language. But before going to the part of the syllabus, I would like to introduce to you what is language. First of all, we should try to understand what is language, whether we need language, and why language is all important for a human being in life. So, to begin with, language. What is language? Language is the expression of human personality in words. I hope you are understanding or following me. Language is the expression of human personality in words. So, language is a link to build relationships. Language is a connection through which we can exchange our thoughts, our ideas, or transform our thoughts and ideas, not only to express ourselves but to learn something from others. So language is very essential, it is a requisite, and we need language to survive on earth. If there was no language, just think, what could have happened? If there was no language, there would have been no contacts, there would have been no communication. So language is very much a requisite, a requirement. Or what do we say, that we cannot live, human beings especially, cannot survive without language. So shall I repeat? We need language for communication. We need language to establish contacts with fellow beings. We need language to transform or exchange our ideas. So man is a social animal, as it has been described by the great Greek philosopher Aristotle. According to Aristotle, man has to live in society. So society is a complex whole. So there are different varieties of people. There are different categories of people. People, especially in India, they speak different languages. People in India, they speak different languages. So, as I was trying to go to the definition of Aristotle, I quoted Aristotle to make you realize that man cannot live alone. Man cannot live in solitude. So, man needs company. Without company, life itself is difficult. So, man needs company. Man needs to survive on this earth. If he wants to survive on this earth, man cannot live alone. Man cannot live in solitude. I hope you are following me. So solitude means a state of loneliness. A state of loneliness which nobody likes. So we all love company. We want friends. We want benefactors. We want our family. Family is a big unit. And family is where we get love and affection. Family is a place where we get love, care, affection. So for any other reasons, what I would like to say is, we are again returning to the point, language. So what is language? Again, I am asking you, or I will try to repeat. I hope you are following me. So language is the expression of human personality. So just try to listen to the definition. Language is the expression of human personality in words. Language is the expression of human personality in words. So, now, language is all the words that have been used by a group of people speaking orally. Writing differs. So oral communication and written communication differs. But prior to that, we are living in a country with a diverse cultures. In our country, people are living in diverse cultures, different languages, different regions, many states, many cultures, many diversities. Amongst them, people are very much connected. They are staying together. Why? They are in touch with each other. So in order to remain in touch with each other, we need language. So what is language? Language is an essence. Language is a requirement. Language is the expression. Even through gestures, we can convey our thoughts, our ideas to others. But gestures do not disclose or do not give the right kind of picture what we are looking for. In order to communicate, in order to transfer your thoughts, the clarity of thoughts, it is only possible when we use the medium of words. Again, returning to the definition, language is the expression of human personality in words. So words are playing a very significant role in expressing our thoughts, ideas. So for that purpose, language is a prerequisite. Language is an essence, and we love to live in this world speaking to each other. So speech is one of the medium of expression. So we use two things while speaking, that is tongue and speech. So through tongue we express the words whatever we are looking for. It is through the voice box the words are coming out, and tongue is playing a key role or a major role in expressing our thoughts and ideas. So thoughts do emerge from the mind, from the brain, and it is through the medium of mouth, tongue, we express, we try to convey our ideas to others. So that's why language, no life, no communication, no life. So now we have come to the part where we are trying to touch that mark, that is expression. So you face some person without speaking, without talking, you cannot say something to others, or they cannot say something to you. So what I mean to say is that we need to speak, we need to express, we need to bring our thoughts and ideas, that is stimulus and response. Stimulus and response is what we learn in the theory in sociology. So man is expecting a response. When you speak, you want someone to say in turn something to you. When you wish good morning, good evening, so the listener, the one who is listening to you, he will also respond. So when he is responding to you, then the purpose of your communication is served. Now coming to the factor, what is communication? What is communication? Communication is nothing but expression of thoughts, ideas, exchanging of ideas as well as thoughts. Now, in order to communicate, what is required? So just try to go back what we were discussing from the last few minutes. We are trying to express language and its significance in the life of a man. So how language helps to build the relationships, how language takes us from solitude to unity, company, and all that. So now coming to the point, communication. So communication is very much a process of exchanging ideas as well as thoughts. What is communication? Communication is nothing but exchanging of thoughts and ideas. So no communication, no life. No language, no life. So now it is very much what we are trying to aim at or look at, that language plays a vital role. It is a tool, it's a very important tool in communication. Language is a very important tool in communication, and language plays a key role in order to help man to meet others, greet others, and to learn from them. So whatever it is, whether if we are expecting an answer from other, we use the medium of language. So communication are of two types, oral communication and written communication. Now, what is oral communication? In oral communication, we express words that come out from our mouth, or what do we say, orally. Whereas written communication is a systematic, it is followed by the rules of grammar. So grammar is very much taken care of in case of written communication. Whereas oral communication, we may commit so many mistakes, but oral communication helps us to send messages to the receiver directly. So direct message can be given through oral communication, whereas written communication demands grammar, accuracy, and economy of words. The more the words, the text will be very much going the roundabouts. That is what we call periphrases. So in order to avoid periphrases, in order to avoid or going roundabouts in expressing our thoughts, what we have to do is we need to use the economy of words. We have to be very economical in the usage of words. So economy helps us to communicate or exchange our ideas, and the listener will also enjoy it, and the listener will receive with positivity, and there will not be the loss of time. So we are not consuming time, we are not putting much of labor, but our thoughts are reaching from one end to another end. So this is how language and communication are necessary. So no language, no life, no communication, no life. So otherwise we have to live in alienation, separately. We have to sit like the rishis in the forest doing meditation, but still their communication is with God. They believe that they are communicating, they are sitting in enlightenment, they are waiting for receiving some enlightenment from the God side. They are expecting so many good things. Now again, coming to the society, we are living in the society where we have a big mass of people, good number of people, and those people always love to be together, to speak together, and to remain together. I hope you have enjoyed this part of the session, and further we are trying to look at the written communication. So written communication is very much grammatical, usage of words I have told you, but at the same time we can see that there is a lot of difference between written and oral communication. With this, I conclude this session. I hope you have loved this small session. If you are very much interested, kindly like my video and subscribe my video. So let us meet again. Take care. God bless you. Thank you.